Oh my god, Dave, no, don't. Hey, what's up, everyone? Okay, I'm back yet again. And this time we are changing it up a little bit. I am doing a reaction to Dave Chappelle's Sticks and Stones, Fame Changes Their Perspective. So let's get into this and we'll be right with you. Okay, here we go.
Goddamn sick of it. This is the worst time ever to be a celebrity. You're gonna be finished. Everyone's doomed. Michael Jackson has been dead for 10 years, and this nigga has two new cases.
Wait, I missed that. What? Let's rewind. Dead for 10 years, and this nigga has two new cases. Do you know what I missed? I can't hear probably.
If you haven't watched that documentary, then I'm begging you, don't watch it.
Oh, I just got it. Okay, just got it.
I felt like HBO was sticking baby dicks in my ears for 4 hours straight.
Baby dick.
Really nasty shit. I want to know all these things. Turns out, Michael Jackson allegedly likes a long gander at the anus. As they said, he stares at people's buttholes. That's what they said. That's how gross the documentary was.
People have their likes and dislikes.
I'm gonna say something that I'm not allowed to say. But I gotta be real. I don't believe these motherfuckers. Believe it. But let me qualify the statement. I am what's known on the streets as a victim blamer. You know what I mean? If somebody come up to me like, Dave, Chris Brown just beat up Rihanna. I'll be like, well, what did she do?
You guys know how I feel about that type of subject.
Dang, Michael Jackson was molesting children. Well, what were those kids wearing at the time?
Oh my god, Dave, no, don't. Oh my god, I think he can't be serious. I think he's just talking smack for this comedy thing. I think it's different because he has power and people behind him that could take Michael down. Whereas the kids that were no ones, who's going to believe them and who's going to care? I think that's the difference.
The first kid I'm fucking, I'll tell you that right now.
Not if there's like a huge team behind him that would take him down, man. No.
I'd be a goddamn hero. Hey, that guy over there fucked the kid from Home Alone. And you know how hard he is to catch.
Clever.
did that shit.
Obviously.
And it was bad, okay? So a couple years ago, I was doing a show in Detroit, and I'm sitting backstage in my dressing room. A friend of mine comes by, this chick, Dream Hampton. Dream tells me right before I'm going on stage, she goes, Dave, I'm working on a documentary about R. Kelly. Would you like to be in it? And I was like, nah, bitch, I'm cool. I went on stage, I just forgot about the shit. And then 2 years later, the documentary comes out, Surviving R. Kelly. And when it comes out, Dream's promoting the shit, and she keeps bringing me up. She said, I asked Dave Chappelle to be in my documentary, and he said it was too hot for TV. Bitch, I did not say that. It does not even sound like how I talk. Oh, that's too hot for TV. I would never say that shit. But I'm going to tell you guys why I wasn't in the documentary.
Tell us,
Dave. Very simple reason. And I cannot stress this point enough. The only reason that I didn't do it was because, and it's very important, I don't know this nigga at all.
Fair enough.
I don't know anything that they don't tell me about. I don't hang out with this nigga. Nothing. So what the fuck do I got in the documentary for? This guy, I only got enough sex tape out now. Can you believe that shit? This guy makes more sex tapes than he does music. He's like the DJ. Boy, I'm like, damn, man. It's a lot of tapes. The new one's so bad that they didn't even show it. I've never seen anything like this. The prosecutor in Chicago came out at a press conference and read to the media a transcript of a sex tape. Have you ever heard of such thing? This nigga read the sex tape.
What?
And it was so bad that R. Kelly sounded guilty in the transcripts. Fucking amazing. 16 times the girl's age was mentioned. Isn't that crazy? This motherfucker is an idiot. He was fucking like, yeah, this is the best 14-year-old pussy I've ever had.
Is that true? Like, I didn't know that was a thing that they had that. What?
Oh, yeah, I love this fucking. I'm like, man, you need to shut the fuck up. You gotta give your lawyer something to work with. You're supposed to be on the tape like, this is the best 36-year-old pussy I've ever had in my life. Then your lawyer can be like, Your Honor, clearly my client thought that this woman was 36, as he mentioned some 16 times in the tape. They're gonna know you're lying, though. You know what I mean? Everybody knows there's no such thing.
Yeah. I expected, but mixed emotions. He's funny, but I have like my standpoint on certain things, obviously, but yeah, it's all right. You know, that's the first one I watched of him. You know, I wasn't the biggest fan of Bill Burr when I first watched, so maybe he'll grow on me as well. But thank you for watching. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, follow my Instagram, MLPots, and I'll be back soon, and we shall reunite very soon. Thanks for watching.
Our supporters help make all this content possible, so make sure you check out our Patreon page so you can help us bring you the content you want.
Push the pedal to the freaking metal. I'm turned up just like heavy metal. Yo. Turned up on another level. Push the pedal to the freaking metal. I'm turned up just like heavy metal.